Let us see the conversion of delta configuration into star configuration. So for which, what we do is that, let us take the delta and assume that any two terminals. So as like this. So for the time being, let us assume this network is not connected anywhere. Only three nodes are there, A, B, C, in which if I need the resistance between A and B, how much I'll get? Is that RAB is equal to, I had given some assumption. What is the assumption? Is that this network is existing as it is like this. No other element connected at C end. If no other element is connected at C, RB and RA is connected in series, right? So now can I say that equivalent resistance is RA plus RB? That series combination is in parallel with RC. That is what the equivalent resistance seen between AB terminals. So this is in parallel with RC. Now can I say its value is RC into RA plus RB by RA plus RB plus RC. This is what RAB, just with the assumption that no element is connected at C. Thereby RA and RB is in series. Otherwise, if some element is connected at C, then this expression is not valid. So what we would like to see here is that what will be the equivalent resistance between AB when it is in delta configuration? In the same way, what will be the equivalent resistance between AB when it is in star configuration? Then this will help us in conversion. Let us see in star configuration what is the resistance between AB. As I told you that if C is not connected anywhere, then no question that if some element is hanging in the air, then it is equivalently saying that it can be removed. Means no effect of this resistance RC. So then in that point of view, you will have only two resistors. What are they? RA and RB. If this got removed, why? Because C is not connected anywhere. Just it is hanging in the air as like this. Now can I say in this point of view, the equivalent resistance is RA plus RB. Now let us call this as equation number 1, this as equation number 2. So if these two networks are equal each other, then we can say equation number 1 is equal to equation number 2. So in this point of view, we will get this as RA plus RB is equal to this entire expression. RA plus RB is equal to this value. Let us call this as equation number 3. In the similar manner, you can make the other equations, that as RBC. How much is RBC between B and C? When I am looking at B and C, RB and RC is in series. That combination is in parallel with RA. So let us see that. So RA into RB plus RC divided by RA plus RB plus RC. If you want, you can name it as 4. In the same way, in Y configuration or star configuration, now let us assume this connection is there. Between B and C, how much I will get? RB plus RC. So RBC I'll get as R small b plus small c. Okay, so this C may hamper. Sometimes here C is there, capital C, here small c is there. For which what I will do is that, so I already made these many things. So I will try to make, just for sake of avoiding the confusion, but no matter that. So what value you are assuming? I will consider R1, R2, R3. so that there is no confusion between small case letter and capital case letter. This is R1 plus R2. Next is here also R1 plus R2. Here R2 plus R3, right? BC means between this R2 plus R3. Now when once we equate this 4 and 5, then we can get some resultant equation which is R2 plus R, sorry, this with the R3, R2 plus R3 is equal to this expression. Okay, so let us call this as equation number 6. Next, similarly, you can try the other thing, last one, RCA. How much we get between C and A? Between C and A, RA, RC look like series. So, RA, RC, that means RB into RA plus RC by RA plus RB plus RC, three resistors. Let us call equation number 7. Similarly, in Y configuration, what do we get? RCA is equal to C means 3, A means 1, so 3 plus 1, R3 plus 1, right? Between C and A, R1 plus R3. Let us call this as 8. So, once we equate these two, what do we get? Both are CA, CA, right? So, this is capital letter. So, what do we get? R1 plus R3 is equal to this expression. This expression. Now, see all these equations which are very much important. This is 9. So, now try to see 3, 6, 9. From equation number 3, 6, 9. Can you do something that to get other values? So, as like this. If I'll make in this way that if I'll subtract 6 from 6, 3 minus 6, what I'll get? R1 plus R2 minus R2 minus R3. R2 R2 will get cancelled. What is left out? R1 minus R3. So, let me write here. So, from these three equations, we can make this kind of thing. 3 minus 6. It gives some equation. What is that equation? Is R1 minus R3. How much is the equivalent in the right side? You cross verify. So, numerator, what are the values? RA, RC, RB, RC. Here, RA, RB, RA, RC. What is common? RA, RC is common in numerator. In denominator, however, this entire thing is RA plus RB plus RC. Here also RA plus RB plus RC. So, what left out is that common thing I will try to highlight, then later on you can work out. So, what is the common thing here? RA, RC, RA, RC. This section is common. This section is common. Product. Remain thing is not common. So, what do we get? RB, RC. RB, RC. Here, minus, RA, RB divided by denominator is same. So, I can write this as RA plus RB plus RC. Clear? I hope this is clear. You take some time and try to carefully simplify these things. Then after having this, I will try to bring the equation number 9 to this picture. So, this is the equation number 9. Then put under this. Now you will get some idea what can be done. Equation number 9. If I will add 3 minus 6 equation with this, will I get any advantage? these are two equations. So if I'll add, what I'll get? 2R1 is equal to this entire thing, in which again what is common? C, RA, RB, here plus RA, RB, that will go away. What is left out? RB, RC, first term, second term, and this term will get cancelled. What is left out is again RB, RC, divided by denominator remains same, RA plus RB plus RC. So now try to simplify this equation further, and what do we get is that here 2 is there. Why? Because RB, RC. So let me take one more step, and 2R1 is equal to 2 RB RC divided by RA plus RB plus RC. What is R1 finally? RB into RC divided by R1 plus R2 plus R, sorry, RA plus RB plus RC. This is the interesting result. Similarly, so you can get other two resistors. What are they? R2 and R3. I'll give simple trick for this. You no need to remember this formula. You can see here in this way. When I put this configuration, this delta configuration, I want to convert into star configuration. This is what the conversion. So if I will convert these values, means I have RA, RB, RC, these values are there with me, that might be given. What values I need is that between ABC, same nodes, this is what ABC, between those same nodes, I need to put R1, R2, R3 in the star configuration, so that I can say these two are equivalently same. So for this kind of conversion, then I can simply use this technique as in this way. Let me elaborate a little bit and try to observe. This is very much helpful. So many times we use these things. Let me remove this. And you no need to remember anything, just in a simple way as like this you can do. So this is RC. Now what I need to do is that this I would like to convert into star. This is given delta. So I would like to convert this into star. What I will do is that first I will try to identify what are the three nodes A, B, C. Between A, B, C, I will try to arrange some three virtual elements in this way. Here some resistance might be there. Here also one more resistance might be there. Here also one more resistance might be there. Let me connect that with little thick lines. Here one resistance, here one resistance, here one resistance. Could you see this? Now could you able to check this pink color one? Look like a star. Now what I will do is that with this same notation which I adapted over here, R1 is connected to A. So that is what R1. This may be R1, this may be R3, this may be R2. Now I already derived R1, so can I write R1 in this way? Just try to see carefully. This is very important. Assume that you are sitting on R1 branch. That branch value I need, for which you have two hands, left side and right side. What are its corresponding resistors, existing resistors? One side is RB, other side is RC. Yes or no? So I can say R1 is equal to, my left side resistance is something, let us say RB, other side resistance is RC. So product of these two, RB into RC, let me write side by side. आर बी इंटू आर सी डिवाइडेड बाई सम ऑफ द डेल्टा कनेक्टर रेसिस्टर सिंपली. सो आर ए प्लस आर बी प्लस आर सी. नाउ विद दिस टेक्निक यू टेल मी वट माइट बी द आर टू इफ आई डेराइव
फॉर आर सी आर ए
यू गो एंड सिट ऑन द सेम रेसिस्टर आर टू विच यू नीड देर यू सी दैट वट इज यूर राइट साइड वट इज यूर लेफ्ट साइड. सो विच इज आर ए इंटू आर सी डिवाइडेड बाई सम ऑफ द डेल्टा रेसिस्टेंस दैट इज आर ए प्लस आर बी प्लस आर सी. इज इट इजी इज इट नेसेसरी टू रिमेंबर द फॉर्मूला. No, just in simple way you can imagine like you are sitting over here. To your left side what is the resistance? To your right side what is the resistance? Product of those, that is what Ra into Rb divided by Ra plus Rb plus Rc. Got my point? These are the R1, R2, R3. Now after getting this, what we do is that we would like to replace this delta configuration by new calculated values. So I will try to replace this old values, just I will remove completely which are thick lines previously, then only this new values which are R1, R2, R3 is there, I will make those as thick lines. Now over, your conversion is over. See how smoothly we converted without any mistake. So that delta I converted into star. What are these new value is R1. How much is R1 is this much. Similarly R2, R3. So like this we can make the conversion of the delta configuration into star configuration. Got the point?
Sir.
Yes, please.